Jewish community, and you're going to hear a lot of them today. This is a very, I have enormous admiration for her. She's the blogger known as Atlas Shrugs, or Pamela. Okay. First of all, I want to thank my Yid Army for showing up. I love my Yid Army. I want to thank my Yid Army for showing up. Thank you so much for coming out in the rain. And I want to, and thank you, Beth, for putting this together. I think it's appropriate that it's raining. There's a reason why it's raining. There's a reason why it's raining. For the first time in American history, we have an anti-Israel president. His premise is false. The narrative is false. The Islamization of the narrative must stop. It must stop with the truth. And truth is the new hate speech. I ask you, what is a settler? I reject that term. I don't want anyone ever to use it again. It's a Jew living in the Jewish homeland. There are no settlers in Israel. What is the West Bank? It is not the West Bank. It's Judea, Judea, and Samaria. No occupation except the Muslim occupation of Israel. I ask you also, where does history start? Where should we start history? Who decides? Should it start 5,768 years ago with the Jewish people? Should it start 1,400 years ago with Muhammad when he beheaded an entire tribe, the Jews of Medina? Kharaiza, the Kharaiza tribe? Who decides? Does it start in 1921 when the Palestinian Mufti of Jerusalem wiped out the Jews in Hebron? Does it start in 1929 when the Palestinian Mufti of Jerusalem wiped out the Jews again? Does it start in 1941 when the Mufti went to Iraq and aligned with Rashid Ali and wiped out the Jews in Iraq? Where does it start? I am asking you. The new narrative is that Zionism is racism. So how far away is that? That Judaism is racism. We are 5 to 10 years away from Europe. Europe, who President Obama wants so desperately to emulate. You ask your brethren in Europe. You ask them what it's like if they wear a kippah in parts of Belgium and Copenhagen, London, Paris. That's where we're going. How dare President Obama jab his finger in the chest of Netanyahu while bowing to the Muslim king of Saudi Arabia? I implore you to reject the Jewish leadership that has failed the Jewish people in Israel. I tell you that 6 million Jews are crying and calling out from their grave. And you know what they're saying? They're saying, stop fetishizing us. Stop building memorials to us. What you should be doing is saving the 6 million in Israel where the next Holocaust is being planned. Elected officials, you hold them to account. People say, what can I do? You can do a lot of things. You get involved in local elections. Chuck Schumer yesterday decides to make a nice statement about Israel. I'm not buying it. We gotta dump Chuck. We gotta dump Schumer. Dump Chuck. Dump Chuck. Dump Chuck. Dump. This man came out against the nomination of Ambassador John Bolton, who, by the way, was the greatest friend of Israel this country ever had. Officials, you get involved. Listen, if history has taught us anything, anything, it's that the individual can change the course of human events. Today is the beginning. I tell you, we reject Jewish leadership. Why didn't Holmline tell the Jewish day schools to be here? Why aren't the Jewish groups here? Are we going to replicate our failure during World War II when we backed Stephen Wise and not Peter Bergson? I ask you to join a new organization that I started with Robert Spencer called Stop Islamization of America. Go to Facebook, SIOA, because frankly what you have is you have an Islamicized president, and he's just one man, and we have righteousness on our side. So as I leave you today, I implore you, go to my blog, alishrugs.com. You cannot trust the corrupt criminal media who demonizes Israel at every turn. And remember, we got Hashem. Thank you.